Yo, what is up, guys? This is Troy D from the Troy D 24/7 Mall. On point reviews all day, every day. I am super duper 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 excited because yet again we're bringing another 2020 fragrance here. Okay, and this was sent to us by the nice folks at Byredo. So I want to show you guys what they sent me here. Hey Troy, please enjoy the sample of our new fragrance, our newest fragrance, Tobacco Mandarin 2020. And we also included our other night veils so that you have the complete set. Thank you to Melissa and Bibi from Byredo on Melrose, Melrose Avenue, one of my favorite hangout spots. And I'm going to link them, I guess. I'm going to drop their contact details below, but this is Melissa's right here. I want to thank you guys because actually I am getting feedback now that when you guys order, you guys mention you watch it at the channel. So actually, because of that, a lot of the sales reps from different companies are very thankful and they're going to send us more stuff to review. So that's really, really amazing. Keep it up, guys. Again, I'm not asking you, I'm not forcing you to do it, but if you see something in the channel that you buy eventually and you like the review, please make sure to let them know you saw it at this channel, okay? And tell them to send us the goodies, okay? But yeah, so we got the whole Night Veils collection, but of course, the one that we're going to talk about today is none other than Byredo's Tobacco Mandarin Extrait de Parfum. Byredo Tobacco Mandarin Extrait de Parfum. This one right here is 2020 release. I believe it will release either this week or next week. Let's go talk about it today. I'm so excited. Let's hit the music. We're back, guys. Byredo's Tobacco Mandarin 2020. Let's go spray it. Oh, yes. Man. Okay. So, Tobacco Mandarin, actually, I was very excited when I heard about this. I mean, some people floated the images online, and I said to myself, man, we're so lucky to be in Los Angeles. It's just like New York. I mean, we have everything within reach. A lot of these really nice top fragrance houses have their own boutiques. And if you guys have seen the Frederick Mall that I did something like that. I reckon once this pandemic kind of lessens down, I mean, because in LA, they have really strict rules when it comes to the shops opening and closing. It's not like OC. So one of these days, I'll take a visit and I'll do a very similar video with Byredo. So again, I want to thank Bibi as well as Melissa. So Tobacco Mandarin really, really got my attention. Why? Because this is a combination, just some by the names, it's a combination of two notes I really like, tobacco and mandarin, obviously. You've seen me have many orangey mandarin fragrances. And of course, tobacco is the mind-blowing note that a lot of people love. Now, as you can see in the juice, it's very dark, you know, and this is an extrait de parfum. Really, this is for the incoming fall and winter. I'm telling you guys, okay? So the start of this one is mandarin orange. And the mandarin orange here is actually, and you won't really notice it, but, you know, because if you do mandarin orange by itself, it's like bright and fruity. But this one is like mandarin orange, but like fall-like, because there is a minor nuance here. This is mandarin orange combined with cumin and coriander. You have the cumin, which is a slight sort of, you could say sort of animalic a little type of scent, but it's very low, okay? Very low level of cumin, very low level of coriander. When you spray this, you're going to get a prolonged mandarin combined with those two type of scent. And automatically, you know, this is great for the fall, automatically, because once you spray it, it is a prolonged, and it's extrait, right? It's prolonged, it's beaming out of you, really nice mandarin combined with cumin and coriander, but it's a while, You know, it's like there's just like stage of just that. So that I really enjoyed, okay? And that really told me, like, man, you know, I can just imagine the winds, you know, like being somewhere where it's cold and windy. And so you will get wafts of this stuff. It's really, really nice, okay? And then I also believe that the cumin and the coriander is actually a nice, nice bridge, okay? Into what? Into first the tobacco, okay? So the tobacco here is very interesting. It is not the same as your Carlisle's or your Side Effects, where the tobacco is actually the main dominant player. This one here, the tobacco is well blended in, okay? So the Mandarin Orange really never goes away, okay? But then the tobacco comes in, adds another punch of, man, like I like the notes. It's like, oh man, here comes the tobacco. But also, it's a nice transition into the leather and incense combination that's in here in Tobacco Mandarin. So believe it or not, leather and incense here in Tobacco Mandarin, care of Olibanum Labdanum. I like this combination because, you know, leather fragrances, in my opinion, just, you know, checking out my friends' collections and people that I know, they're very, you know, careful with leather. You only see people really with the leather, you know, with like maybe popular ones, Tom Ford Ombre leather, you know, Tuscan leather. And they swear by the leather. But in my opinion, just looking at, and it's just my opinion, just looking at just the people around me and the people I see, a lot of them are kind of, you know, very careful with leather. Why? Because sometimes these leather scents are like outright, like the leather comes out very striking, and a lot of people, in my opinion, are just not ready for that stuff. This one here, I can say, is well blended in leather. And you can even barely, I mean, you can really smell it if you sniff your wrist. But as the wearer for me, like, it's just a nice, perfect, well-blended leather with the incense. So you never really have a standout leather like, hey, what's up here? I'm the leather. It's leather and incense, guys. Plus the likable notes of tobacco and the mandarin. One thing I can say about this fragrance right here is that none of these notes, other than maybe the mandarin, really stick out that you can pick them out one by one. Which means this is a very good fragrance that transitions quite well. You can't even detect the transition. Sometimes it feels like it's just one fragrance. It's one whole thing together. And I really like how Byredo did, you know, kind of like how the cumin and the coriander transitions into like the tobacco or the leather and incense. Very wonderful incense right here, and leather, perfect for fall and winter. Now, interestingly, the dry down here has oud. It's olibanum, sandalwood, and oud. Okay, and upon spraying this and letting it last for about a few hours, you know, I can really smell the olibanum, the oud. I don't know, it feels like a mainstream type of oud. That's in here, maybe kind of sweet and bitter at the same time. It's perfect. It goes well with the sandalwood. You know, I love sandalwood as well. And again, olibanum. Really nice dry down as well. But I think that the main points here in Tobacco Mandarin is the nice mandarin intro, the mandarin opening that lasts for a while, goes through that phase, and then perfectly transitions in your tobacco as well as your leather and incense combination. Okay, I think that this is for a fashion forward man. Okay, fashion forward man. It's not classic. Oh, it's not like a classic, like you smell it and it's like, it seems like a classic perfume. I think this is a very fashion forward perfume. I think that it can be worn by both guys and girls. Why? Because like I said, the leather doesn't denote like masculine. It's actually blended in with the incense and transitions from the mandarins, which is very unisex. So in my opinion, this Tobacco Mandarin is definitely 100% unisex. But for me as a guy, I will say that it is for fashion forward men, okay? And it is also for those that are, maybe you appreciate just a well-blended perfume. Because there are some people, like, I sometimes like notes that stand out, notes that say, hello, I'm here, but actually, I do appreciate well-blended perfumes that just come as almost like one perfume, one smell, one combination. I think it's very nice. It's also a very, I think that the longevity intensity of this is very high, because also obviously it is an extrait de parfum, but also like when I tested this, the intensity lasted and lasted and lasted. And I think, because I told you guys, right, the mandarin never really goes away, I think they put a nice punch of the mandarin here, because all the way to the dry down you can still smell the mandarin, and sometimes the olibanum will contribute a little bit of that citrusy part into the mandarin, maybe, so you could like think that it's there. But for me, the mandarin lasts through and through. Tobacco, nice supporting actor, it's still there, very pleasurable, nice tobacco, not super standout. Again, this is a well blended fragrance, okay? And this would appeal to anybody that maybe you guys like Parfums de Marly, right? Reason being, a lot of the PDMs are well blended in my opinion. They come out as one effect, and that's why a lot of the mainstream really likes them. And I think that this Tobacco Mandarin is in the same way. Transitions are, man, really, you can't really detect a lot of the transitions. As the wearer, once you smell it, boom, it's going to emanate. It's an extrait. It's going to come out. And it does have a lot of good, you know, nice, man, when you smell it, like wafts of it. It's like, oh, man, here's mandarin. Here's the tobacco. Here's the incense. Okay? You're going to get those kinds of feelings as you wear Tobacco Mandarin. And I do highly recommend this for the fall and the winter. Okay, so hope you guys and gals try this out. Again, I'm going to put the Byredo contact details for Hollywood, but you guys can check it right here. You can call them anytime. I think it's like 1 to 5 p.m. or something like that, or 11 to 5 p.m. In Los Angeles. And you can contact them if you want to get samples from them so you can try them. Let them know, you know, tell them you saw it in the channel, or if you want to order it. But I think it's a really nice fall winter fragrance. You know, it's really nice. I'm a big fan of mandarin, and I'm a big fan of tobacco. I'm a big fan of incense. And again, for those that are very careful about leather, you're gonna like it. It's not even super standout, really. You know, it just gives that leather incense combo rather than a leather fragrance where it's like a standout leather fragrance. Okay, perfect for those curious about leather. All right, so that's it. That is my review of Byredo 2020 Tobacco Mandarin. Again, I want to thank Byredo for sending me this. Byredo Los Angeles, you guys are the best. Melrose, one of my favorite places to visit and hang out. Man, I miss Earth Cafe. Okay, anyways, if you like this video, make sure you guys like and subscribe. Obviously, I will be doing the rest of the Night Veils collection, and I will start maybe giving a little bit of information about the Frag Cartel. I think it's almost time, right? So, until then, this is Troy D. God bless you guys. Have a great day. Talk to you soon.